Hello YouTube, my name is Elise and I'm coming at you with another video. And this time it's gonna be all about military spouse benefits. So let's get into it. Well, I have been gone for a really long time, but I do wanna thank my subscribers for keep subscribing and thank you guys for keep asking me questions. I'm sorry if I haven't responded, but I've been extremely busy, just had a baby, so. Yeah, I'm gonna get into this video and hopefully I'm able to stay consistent with it. Keep your fingers crossed. So first benefit that I want to go over is ACS. So ACS is Army Community Services. Now, I do want to caveat that by saying that obviously it's Army Community Services, but there are, in every branch, there's probably a equivalent to ACS. So for the ACS, one of the things that they do offer is that there is a financial advisor. The benefit of the financial advisor that it serves to you is that they will go over retirement, investment, budgeting. So if you're a new family and you're just starting off, it is great to start your budget. Me and my husband has used ACS for a number of different things. We've gone to ACS to see a financial advisor for a TSP, and then we've seen ACS for budgeting. So we have seen them multiple times. Their financial advisors are super helpful. And the best benefit about the things that ACS provides to you, it's free. Also, domestic violence. If you are going through that in your relationship, ACS does have people there to help you with that as well. Just go and try to figure out what the next steps are when you're going through things like that. So they're just a great thing that's there. A lot of people don't use them, and you should, because it's free and it's there for you. If anything, you know, goes wrong, they're there to help. The next thing I'm going to talk about is AER loans. AER loans are emergency relief funds that are for service members and their families whenever they're having financial issues, whatever that may be. If you can't make your bills one month, or if something came up and you're short, or even if you have a family emergency that you need to attend to, surgeries, things like that, AER loans are there to help you, and they are there to help you. And the service member usually has to go through their chain of command to get them. They are interest-free loans, and if you need it, just go to ACS and ask them about it and how to go about applying for one. Not only are you taking it out, but you can also donate to it and have an automatic allotment from your check to make sure to donate to that fund. And it's for service members, and it's just to help out whenever they're in need. So it's actually pretty great if you ask me. Another benefit that a lot of people don't know about is that there are scholarships out there for spouses. So there's a MyCAA scholarship, and this scholarship is up to $4,000 that spouses can get, and it's usually towards an associate's degree. So if you already have your bachelor's or your master's, usually you can't do this program. But if you're going towards an associate's degree or certain certifications as you're trying to get there, MyCAA scholarships, please do some research on that. It is for certain ranks, usually lower enlisted people, and as well as junior officers as well are eligible for it. Spouses are eligible for it. So if you're thinking about going to school, getting some education and some certifications or some licenses, I would definitely look into MyCAA scholarship. And that you could go through Military OneSource. Military OneSource is actually a great source for that. They're online, and you could go on there and you could call them and you can ask about different things. So going into Military OneSource, that is one of the biggest benefits. Me and my husband use Military OneSource, especially when it comes around to tax times. They do have tax professionals there that can help you prepare your taxes. Like for me and my husband, sometimes our taxes get super complicated. You know, just because we both have jobs and we're moving and residency and things like that, then, you know, it kind of gets a little bit confusing. So they do have tax professionals there to help you with your taxes if you need it. And it's free. So, I mean, you can't go wrong with free. And then also Military One Source, we've used it for investment. We've looked into 529s for our sons going to college and making investments into that. There's also counseling that you could get on there too. I've never used it for that before, but there are like relationships counseling, whatever you need it for, whatever issues that you're going through, there's always a resource out there that can help you, point you in the right direction. And the next thing is something that it has a lot of drama on it, but can actually be used for good, is the military spouse Facebook pages. So wherever you move to, almost every military base I've ever been at, there's a spouse page for it. And this spouse page is extremely helpful because what happens is these spouses end up knowing a lot more than the service member knows. And I find out so much stuff off the spouse pages. If I have questions about what's going on base, I can go on the spouse page. And it's just an easy tool. Now, there is some drama up there. There is some juicy stories you see. And you like, you know, you start digging into it and you like, whoa, what's going on here? But neither here nor there, that's just for entertainment. Don't feed into that. But it also can be used for good as well to find out what's going on base. Why is this road closed? Is Starbucks open? You know, different things like that. What's the new procedures at the gate? You know, especially with COVID and things changing constantly. The spouse page is probably your best bet to get the most up-to-date information as it's happening. It's for spouses who have, for employment for spouses, if you, when you PCS or you relocate as a military spouse, you can have, and you have like licenses and certificates to do whatever job that you're doing. The military will give you up to reimburse you up to $1,000 for you to get retrained in whatever state that you move to. So that's actually a really good source. I don't have all the details on it, so I definitely would just look into it. Look on Military One Source or call them, and I'm pretty sure they'll be able to give you all the information that you need to make sure that you can get reimbursed when you move, like if you're a teacher, different states, you know, different certificates, things like that. And you could definitely get that reimbursed for up to $1,000. And I thought that was a really cool thing. And it's pretty fairly new that they're doing this, that the military is doing this. So take advantage of it, you guys. It's a great source. You don't have to keep paying for licenses every time you move. As that actually brings you to the end of my video. I am going to dig into these benefits a lot more for you guys because I think a lot of people don't know what the military has to offer, so sometimes we don't use it. So I'm just gonna do more videos. I'm gonna break it down to education, employment, just so you guys can know everything that's out there. I'm gonna make sure I research everything and have it out, give you guys the information, you know, to be the best military spouse you can be, full capacity. So thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, and let me know if you have any comments. Thank you.